Hey y'all, I'm James Wright and welcome to the shop. Today I want to talk about marking knives. It is a very basic tool to have in the shop, but it is one of those tools that really is a necessity. So I have a few of them here and I want to talk about pros and cons, where I use them, where I don't use them, and what I look for when I'm picking out my marking knife. Let's dive in. Now, this here is just a basic collection of knives. Most of them I've had over the years, I've given away for one reason or another. There's always been another woodworker who needs them. And it was very quickly that I came along the one that I really like. And this one was made by Dan the Maker Man. I'll try and leave a link to that video down below. It's made of an old saw plate. It's very, very thin. It's about 0.06. Really, really thin. It's double bevel, but it has this nice long flat edge here. It has a rounded surface and it just feels really good in the hand. I really like this finger indent. It comes in here really nicely. This is basically everything I want in a knife. And once I found this one, every other knife I've tried since then I've gotten rid of. So this is the one that I use day in and day out. I usually have a box cutter utility knife, and this is one that I carry with me quite a bit. And I've used this as a marking knife in the past. Because it's so thin, it really doesn't matter much on the bevel, but there isn't a large flat surface like this that I can reference off of. So I like to have this in my pocket for opening boxes, but I don't use it that much for marking knives. This is one I picked up a while ago at an MWTCA meet, and it's really more of a carving knife. But because it's so thin, it really works in there. It feels really good in the hand, but I use this one more for carving. But it does work as a marking knife. The first one I ever had was an X-Acto knife. I really like this one with the nut back here, so you tighten it and loosen it back here rather than up here. That way I can hold it like a pen and get detailed on here. The problem is this blade is so thin and so flexible, I would find it wobbling all over the place, and it was hard to get a really nice clean line with an X-Acto knife. Next, we have a chip carving knife, and this really is for chip carving. It's not as much for marking, but I really like it because the bevel is the total width of the shank, so the bevel comes all the way up both sides here, so there isn't a smaller bevel right at the edge. And so when I want to get into things, it makes it very easy to reference off of this side or reference off of this side. It's a little longer there so I can work down into my dovetail. So this works out really well. This was a cheapo that I was given probably about 5 or 6 years ago. And it is one you can buy on Amazon. It's very cheap, but it's a big thick blade on here. I'm not as much of a fan of the big thick blade. I'll be talking about it a little later, but I'm starting to get into the double bevel on this, which I kind of like that because I could hold it like a pin. There's this finger rest in here, and I can always reference off this side or rotate around, reference off this side, and that way I can do it either way I wanted it. Then there are these two, which will be coming out on Saturday. These are ones that I'm making, so these will be Saturday's video, so you'll have to wait for that. So first off, the most common way to use a marking knife is with a square. You set it on here, and you put your flat side against there, very light, then medium, and then a heavy cut. And you've got this gorgeous line. Everything on one side of the line stays, everything on the other side of the line goes. And for using a square, just about any of these will work just as well. With this one here, I can set the flat edge against there and I can come across this way. And then if I need to flip it around this way, then I can try not to slice my wrist because I'm doing it left-handed and come across that way. I can just reference one side or the other. With this one, I can either do it on this side here or I can flip it around and I can put the flat side on the other side here. For using a square, most any knife will work fine. It just depends on how you like to hold it. This is really where this finger indent comes in well on this, is I like to actually hold it like a pencil, or I can hold it up here if I want to put a little bit more pressure. I can get my finger right on there and hold hog down on this and really cut in deeply. Or I can hold it like a pencil, put my finger up in here and cut in that way. Having that little finger indent makes it just a little bit more accurate. It makes it very easy to put this exactly where I want it. The next place I want to do is I want to reference a board onto another surface. And I find this a lot of times when I'm doing joinery and I want to transfer the mark from one board onto the other. And this is where having a large flat surface on here works out really well. I can put that flat surface against here, reference against there, keep it nice and flat on there, and I can draw my line all the way across. I'm not having to come in at an angle and try and match up my bevel to hold it down in there. It just becomes a little more pain to do it that way. This way I can hold it nice and flat on there, and I know I'm referencing a really nice edge down on there, and I'm putting this line exactly where it needs to go. That way when I pull it away, I know that line is exactly where I need to cut. If I'm doing that with a knife like this, well, number one, it's too short, and so I'm going at an angle like this, and there's a chance that either I'm going to ride up the board, or I'm going to be pushing the board away because I'm trying to dig underneath it. And putting it at a weird angle like that is just a pain for anything that's shorter than this. It doesn't have that shank to sit in there. And something like this, it's the same double bevel design, but because it's so short, I can't quite get in there. And that's where using a utility blade or something like that even has problems. I'm not going to be going straight down on the board. I'm coming at an angle, which kind of makes it tuck underneath. And I'm not getting an angle that I really like as much. Also, there's the problem of it then riding up the board as opposed to going across the line. Next, if I'm ever transferring the lines that are back in a hole or something of that nature, I want to be able to reach all the way back in there. And so in this case, with this long shank, I can reach in there. I know it's flat. I can reference off of each of these places at whatever angle they're at. Some of these are going to have a little bit more of a problem. This one is just, it's hard to get down to that corner because it's curved. This one can get down into the corner, but it's just, it's not quite as accurate because I'm riding on the bevel and having to make sure I'm matching my bevel to it as opposed to just keeping the flat at the back on there. So each one is a little bit different in that, but I find that this works pretty well for most everything I need to do when I need to reach back down into a hole. The next thing is the thickness of the blade itself. This is a very, very thin blade. It's like 0.06 inches, and this is one that's a good bit thicker. And I know a lot of people like this thick blade. It feels good, it's a little bit heavier. It allows you to put more work down and more force into the wood. But the problem is, if you're ever doing small joinery, it makes it harder to get in there. If you're ever doing really small pins or things of that nature, you can't get these thick blades in there. And I like to have a really, really thin blade that can stick down into any hole I want. So if I'm doing small pins on a dovetail, this can reach down in there and give me a really nice mark wherever I need it to go. But then on that point, you can get a blade that's too thin and it kind of wobbles around. And one of the problems with the thin blades is if you have a really heavy grain, they'll have a tendency to follow the grain, and wherever the grain goes, the knife will go. If you get something that's really nice and thick and stiff, this will cut really nicely and will stay on your line heavy and true. So I like to have something in the middle, something that's not thin enough that it wobbles around, but yet it's still thick enough that it holds in place. And so it's finding that balance between really thick and really thin, getting something that is stiff enough not to flex, but still thin enough I can get down in there. And so that's where I've really come to on this particular one. And here we've come to the real problem with marking knives, is that they are a very personal preference. Everyone has something different that they like. Some people like more of a squared off handle. Some people like a really, really organic feel to it. Some people like chamfers and edges. Some people like a pocket knife that they always have on them, something you can flip out with a disposable blade. There are so many personal preferences out there that there really is no perfect knife for everyone. And you've got to kind of play around with a few until you find that one that really, really works for you. And one of these days I might find some knife with something that I like more than this one, but I haven't found it yet. So that being said, you know, try a few and see what you like. You might be surprised with, oh, I really didn't think I'd like that. When I first got into it, I didn't think I'd like the double bevel. I had a single bevel kiridashi that I really enjoyed, but the problem with that is if I need to mark on the other side, then I have to like do weird origami with myself in order to make it mark. Having the double bevel makes it very easy to flip over and mark the other side and go in the same direction. So, personal preferences, you gotta figure out what you like. So one of the big reasons why there are so many different types of marking knives out there is everyone likes something a little bit different, and you never quite know what you want until you have a chance to try it. If you want to see some other types of marking knives, Katzmosis Woodworking actually did a video recently going through a bunch of different styles, and he has a collection that's even bigger than mine. And he actually talks a little bit more about their use and particulars, so I'll leave a link to that video down below as well. One of the reasons why this video came to the top of my list is several companies have actually started making a couple that are very close to what I like. This one is from Tay Tools, and he has them with a couple different options so you can get them with different thickness of steel, but they're actually rather similar to what I like with the finger indent. It's a little bit shorter of a head, but for the price, you really can't beat it. They're very affordable. Also, DMF Toolworks, the guy who makes my card scrapers, he has a set of knives that have recently come out, and he has some that are really cool with Damascus steel, a little bit more expensive, but they are a premium tool. So I wanted to leave links to those down below, and play around, see what you like. I would love to hear your thoughts. What are the things that you like in a knife that make it very special to you? A marking knife is a very personal choice, and once you find one that really works for you, it's one of those tools that you always have close to you. It's almost always on your bench or always in your vest or where you normally have your tools. It's within reach. So I hope you like this little discussion. I'd love to hear your ideas and thoughts in the comments down below. Looking forward to reading those. Also want to say a huge thank you to the patrons on Patreon. You guys are the reason why Wood by Wright is here today. I can honestly say if it wasn't for all the patrons scrolling over here on the side, I would not be here today with this channel. So thank you for that. If you'd like to find out more about that, there's a link to patreon.com down below. So I think that's about enough marking knife fun for the day. And until next time, have a wonderful day. Everybody out there named Mark has something special because they have their own knife. Why don't we have a Jamesing knife? I want the Jamesing knife.